All right, boys, let's go. Let's do this THQ Nordic Digital Co-Case Showcase 2022. Let's go. Let's do this. I'm excited, man. I want to see what they're up to, man. Let's go. THQ Digital Showcase.
Damn, boy. He's thick, boy. Damn, boy. That's a sick ass, boy. Damn.
Oh, thanks, man. Thanks, Lex. That's the start of a YouTube video right there. What's happening to the audio? What? There's no audio to start? No, it's just bugged in the beginning? Endling? Okay. Okay, what is this? 56 minutes? Let's go. What's happening with the audio, man? I mean, this is from Nordic themselves, man. It's all right. I guess these showcases do get bugged up sometimes. What is that? De-exit? Oh, this looks interesting. Okay, there we go. There we go. The audio jumped back in. Okay. That's not from me, man. That's from them, man. I'm somewhat of a professional myself. They call me Mr. Professional, dude. Okay, let's see. What's going on here? But they look like a bunch of indie games. What about you? Oh, that gun looks nice. Parish? Let me know if you guys are cool with the audio, man. What is this? Okay, that looks interesting. Smash it to the wall. It looks good, but let me be honest. Looks kind of clunky. Guys, it looks clunky. Okay. Ratatouille. A rat's quest. Okay. Fighting scorpions and shit. Okay. Let's give it a shot. Lethal. Oh, I love this. Oh, this looks good. Oh, now the audio from just jumped up from them, by the way. Janky show. See you at Gamescom. Okay. Hold 10.02. 10.2. I never seen a THQ Nordic showcase before. All the game trailers go Hello, me like, so what do I do in this game? THQ Nordic. Exactly, man. Digital showcase. Dude, their audio is so janky, man.
I'm Ella Tillywood, and we are so glad you're a part of this.
So hold on to your boots. I'm Richard Keese, and we'll be blasting you with a tantalizing array of brand new games and mouth-watering first looks.
Okay.
But that's not all. We also have updates, release dates, and so many other reveals and surprises waiting for you.
You better surprise me, man. But so far, I'm not impressed, sir. The following game footage may contain... Okay, something. Ominous Prime. Let's just close this DC stuff.
Ooh.
That actually freaked me out. What the frick, dude? How are you doing, Graham? Okay, calm down, kid. What the frick's going on? How are you doing, Grandma? How's he doing? Watching THQ thingamajiggum.
It's a battleground.
Maybe the Dark Man just likes it when you suffer.
Maybe the Dark Man just likes to see you suffer. Oh, I like these statues.
Have you ever talked to a doctor about your condition?
What is this, man? This is so interesting.
Are you crazy?
Dude. Oh my god. Oh wow, that's
welcome to the madhouse, detective.
Well, I'm impressed. That looks better than I thought, dudes. That looks good. Holy schmolies, dudes. That's pretty awesome, man.
Alone in the dark is a loving
I'm doing fantastic, sir.
Of the groundbreaking classic survival horror game. Developed by Pieces Interactive.
This guy almost looks like a robot.
In the gothic
like
American
a digital
South,
person.
Players get to enjoy the experience.
Is this guy a digital person?
Emily from the prestigious
hit my shin on so many metal parts of work last night. My legs covered in bruises. Oh my god, DJ, man. That sucks, man. Get better soon, man.
About the paranormal.
There's nothing much you can do about bruises.
Evil rotting at the core of DeSeto Manor. To reveal its dark secret, you must go back to where it all began. Desperate combat, atmospheric puzzles, and a story that gazes deep inside our protagonist's haunted souls.
Haunted souls. You can tell if somebody's just not comfortable with themselves. This guy is so uncomfortable.
Afraid.
He's just not.
Be very afraid.
Yeah, be very afraid. Okay. Man.
The Blisk!
Both of them look CGI? Yeah,
Blisk.
I'm telling you, man.
Wait a minute.
It's like it's so
I
unnatural.
The Blisk out.
I have no explanation, but a few of them must have somehow survived.
Not for what? Long.
Isn't this I know this game,
attention,
man.
Attention, Blisk. I am Cryptosporidium of the planet Furon. This planet is now a territory of the Furon
snap, Grim. Congrats, man.
And your asses belong to me.
Why did it take it long to export? Of course, man. 1 hour. 2 hours on. Isn't this like aliens against humanity? I'm not sure what kind of achievement that is and how you got him on Alpha, but yeah, congrats, man.
You gotta fill me in on this whole Blisk thing.
But there's no humans. Always destroy humans if there's no humans.
Brutes with giant claws and withering halitosis.
Withering halitosis.
Cockroach mating with a lobster.
Oi. Enough already. You're making me queasy.
Do it. It looks like destroy humans. Ah, there you go. There's some humans. Oh! Mutated humans. Okay, I get it now. Hey, how do you, like, you kill a human before? How can you elevate it, yeah? Yeah, I mutate them.
Yeah, well, don't you worry your virtual little head, Cox. This time they're going down for good.
If you like this kind of comedy, you're gonna like this game.
You have to
oh, I love this game already. Looks pretty good to me. The game looking good. You know, it's got like a couple of good potentials going on here.
Starting with their crashed warship. Bring on the boom boom.
Rain on the boom boom.
You are so cute when you do that.
Yeah, this is new, man. Oh no, you never heard of the first game, dude? It's a classic, man, that got remade. Yeah. They saw home humans and they remade it in HD. And it looks like this, the first game actually that's remade, it looks like this.
Oh, very nice.
Looks pretty cool, actually. It's one of those games, it's like, you know, mess around with, just play around with. It's not a serious game, man. We need more like games like this that are not too serious, man. You played the OG and the remake? I was with my friends at his house when he played the remake, man. Very E? Yes, it is very E. It looks pretty cool, man, I ain't gonna lie. It's not bad. Like, if you played the first one, you expect, you know what you expect. Was that Freebird guitar solo? No idea. What is that? What? Okay, I'm intrigued. What is going on here? Ah, our alien boy is here. Hello, Mr. Alien. Help. Oh man, this looks so cute and fun. Dude, I totally play this game. I don't even need to see anything more. This is totally a game I'll play. That's not a hexagon. Hexagons are the bestagons, man. That's not a hexagon. That's why you died. There you go. So you build yourself a base. You get some power. You run away from the enemies. This looks super cool, man. You meet some aliens and shit. You go through different biomes. I mean, this is the kind of thing that a narrator would say. Different biomes, aliens, build your own base.
Space for Sale is an open-ended
this looks awesome.
Simulation game.
I'll play this.
You get to play a cute little astronaut who just bought an entire solar system.
Yeah, I don't and care that I'm covering cheeky, his face. You don't way, even need to see him.
At least compared to London.
Just think about the CGI character. That's him.
Is to build new houses for your eccentric and demanding extraterrestrial.
Imagine he actually watches this video and then like,
explore the world.
Who are you talking about, man? Who's the alien
locations,
in here?
Locations. Gather resources and study and tame the local flora.
It looks pretty sweet, man. I ain't gonna lie. I'll play it. I'd buy
Space
it.
Space for Sale can be played alone or in co-op gameplay.
Ankle
the
off?
Most
sweet.
Adventurous and fun real estate hunt in human and alien
these
history.
Guys are literal NPCs, man. Gothic 1 remake? Sweet. This is the one you were telling me about, right? Oh, snap, dude. Oh, yeah, you start off in a prison camp. Oh, yeah. Wow, look at the difference in the graphics. Holy shit. It's like night and day. What night and day? It's not even related. It's like a different universe between the first one and this one. Holy shit. Did I play No Man's Sky? Yes. I played it a lot as well. I played it on PlayStation though. I didn't play it on PC. I don't have it on PC. I wish I would play it on stream. No problem. I love that game. I got a copy of it like really cheap. Because, you know, the whole controversy, I said, I bet it's going to get better. So I bought it for like an extra nothing. And I still have it. And it's been updating ever since. It's amazing. I'm very interested in playing No Man's Sky in the future. You should play. It's really good, man. But I never played this game, but I watched multiple YouTubers and awesome reviews talk about this game a lot in detail. Gothic.
Come on, let's head back. This is too dangerous.
Man, I think Mandalorian Gaming did it and a bunch of other players. No way, not until we find that step. Oh shit.
Oh no.
Oh no, dude. What the frick? Get out of there, dude. Run, boy. Damn, man. What the frick? PS5, Xbox, PC?
Staying true to the original while modernizing game mechanics and control, Gothic 1 Remake invites you to discover or rediscover the awe-inspiring world of the mining colony on the island Carinus and to learn all the dirty tricks you need to survive.
True.
Take control of the nameless hero, a convicted prisoner whose arrival in the colony might just change everything. On a quest to end chaos in a wild territory.
I really like this chick's hair.
Controlled by violent people.
We need to see more hair like this in the universe.
And hey, couldn't we all use some?
Gothic has
like
three
that?
Third well, place. It's one of my favorite in the showcase. In. Ooh. Third place.
Home. Once it meant my
Jagged
father's
Alliance.
Mansion. But now.
Okay, this looks
gone.
Interesting. I don't know why
after
when they start off a game with an open square like this, I'm interested.
He had his vision for our country. But when they took him, they robbed us all of that dream.
This guy is missing a leg.
We need our home back.
kind of browser is that? Peak find.
This is not. Why would I want it? This is promising. I've heard my father mention them.
Good day. We have tracked your.
Wait a second. She got spam and then I'm like, oh no, that's good actually. Okay, I love the humor already, dude.
How may we be of service?
I am Emma LaFontaine. I want my father back.
Understandable, Miss LaFontaine.
How would this work exactly?
First step is to hire a team. Then they get to work.
First step is to hire a team. Next step, it's done. Oh, it's a turn base. Oh, you might be into this actually, Graham, because you like this is the kind of game, dude. This looks actually pretty sweet house, man. Ain't gonna lie. This is like XCOM. I want my father back. Well, just eat simple 1-2 steps. If higher achieve, get killed. Jagged Alliance goes way back. This is part 3. I don't like some turn-based strategies, though. I really need to get going with that XCOM run. I actually do enjoy myself. It's facts. Oh, this guy can move multiple times and shoot multiple times? Okay, there's all sorts of different strategies happening over here, huh? Alright, you still have the squares on the floor that telling you how much you can move, get cover, Father, all that sort of stuff.
I will save you. And I will get our home back.
I just gave you half a cent. Oh, you watched an ad? It's not even half a cent. It's like probably like 1 cent.
I just need to get the money.
I just need
Jagged
the money.
Alliance 3 combines
that looks actually pretty interesting, man. Gonna lie.
Strategic, open-style gameplay for both solo or online co-op mayhem.
I like it.
Recruit from a large cast of mercenaries. That
look at that guy on the right there, man. That character looks freaking amazing.
Full-on psychotic.
I mean, he's right there for you guys.
To rescue the president of Grand Chien from a paramilitary force, if you so choose to follow your contract, that is. And that mercenary roster, so many of true fan favorites to select from. Jagged Alliance 3 is pulling on the classic heartstrings for true fans, bringing the franchise back to its roots while still adding in a few new features for everyone to enjoy new adventures in Grand Chien, where the worst is yet to come.
Stop acting and doing stuff, weird stuff like so out of your character,
since
dude.
Since you took that damned scepter, you haven't been yourself.
Oh, this game.
You brought us here, then abandoned the fight, abandoned your men, and even abandoned your vows.
Oh my god. Oh, this looks so good. This one is like actually really looking good, man. But across during the fifth, the crusade. You have abandoned your men, you traitor scum!
My lord!
You have been announced!
Brother, there's no turning back!
Traitorus! Excommunicatus traitorus!
Advancing!
You aren't even real, stop acting like a human? Yes! Oh my god, dude. And today you're gonna be watching this video game that's like, and it's crazy! And then you gotta be like, okay. I'm not sold on this game, I ain't gonna lie, but it looks interesting. It's got potential, boys. I like this shit. You know what? I'm kinda sold. I don't know, am I sold? Let me look a little bit more. It's kinda cool. It's like a strategy game, but it's a bunch of grouped guys together. I remember you sent me a trailer for this, Glory. But it was all talking and shit about the story and there was no gameplay, and I was like, oh man, F this game. But now I'm seeing the gameplay.
After all I had to suffer and sacrifice.
Yes, man, I'm in. I totally play this. Holy shit.
You don't make me do this, Theo.
Naruto, Sasuke, come back to the village. That's the conversation.
Sasuke, you're my friend, Sasuke. I'll bring you back. We hanged out together like three times.
The Valiant is a tactical, real-time strategy game where you lead medieval knights.
Alone in the Dark looks really good. It looks really promising.
For a fresh take on RTS, trust me, this is your game. And if online is your
the lizard controlling him is a newbie
with friends in Last Man Standing. Throw. Or test your skills against others in 1v1 and 2v2 competitive.
Godfather of Survival Horror, true.
Throw in New Game Plus, a full roster of unique heroes, each with their own skill trees and multiple difficulty levels, and you have a replayable experience for all types of players to sink their swords into.
This woman here, seeing like, she's less NPC than Guido.
I ask.
Still, she has NPC qualities though.
Confront your former brother in arms and find the missing relic pieces before he does, before he unleashes a power that was never meant for man. Raise your sword and fight valiantly.
Oh my god, that's so PC, man. They're like so NPC looking. Oh my god. Previous games are pretty bad though. Fair enough. Alright, let's see what we got here. Okay, THQ Nordic. Oh, okay. I dig the art style.
You have proven yourself loyal to me so far, General.
Okay, this guy's gonna die. Everybody just looks down a hole like this, gonna die.
Our dynasty has waited long enough.
Dynasty?
Show me that my trust is not misplaced.
Are you talking strategy returns? There's a lot of strategy games, huh? Okay. Interesting. Oh my god. Why do you feel like new? Oh, damn. Holy shit! Dude! Dude!
Strong though they may be,
dude!
They are still flesh and bone.
Dude! Oh. Tempest Rising? Oh my. Oh, dude.
Get to work.
Dude. Tempest, I need this in my life. Is an intriguing, I need this. It looks so good. So far, best game so far. Games, and the whole thing.
Combining base building with hard-hitting combat. The game is set in an alternate 1997.
This looks so good, man.
On a planet
it looks
Earth
so epic, dude.
After the world's first nuclear war. You can choose from three
playable factions. Episodizing successor to CNC? It looks like Command & Conquer 2, right? But better. The graphic, obviously, that game is really old.
Skirmish and multiplayer game modes.
So it
with
has
a
the basic stuff.
Matchmaking system.
As long
in
as
short,
you don't mess it up, man.
This is a must-play for even the most competitive characters and dangerous minds out there.
Don't make it competitive. Make it fun. Just make it fun. Forget about the competitive
Welcome
aspect
back,
of it, man. That's what happens, man. Let me tell you guys. These people like focus so much on when these new RTS is about competitive players, they forget about the fun aspect. Maybe I don't want it to be balanced. Maybe I would just want to nuke the shit out of my enemies. Is that so hard to do? Okay? Damn, son. Hopefully it's not going to turn out bad, man. I got hope. I got hope, dude.
Your kingdom awaits.
You do like your RTS too? Oh. This game. Oh, is this game? Well, you manage
the royal court is eager to hear your
wait. Sorry guys. I'm gonna go back a bit. King Knights of Honor 2. Alright, okay, it's not that one
back,
I was thinking
sire.
About.
Your kingdom.
Because this map reminded me of that game where you manage people like this guy matters this guy and this thing and this thing's happening. Yes. Bohemia?
Court is eager to hear your orders. They've garnered many new skills to serve the realm.
London?
Our diplomats are standing by, Your Majesty.
Use me neither, man.
To seal powerful pacts with our allies.
This
our
looks.
Merchants have established.
Ain't gonna lie, this kind of looks like a ripoff of that other game.
Trade route you requested.
I can't remember the name of it though. Yeah, you don't really manage armies, you manage like influences and stuff.
A well-placed spy could send them into anarchy.
Yeah, but this one looks a little bit more detailed.
To spread to one of our provinces, we should let our priests deal with it, sire.
Crusader Kings, I think.
It is time to recruit the
continent's
greatest army.
Looks so underwhelming after watching the previous one. Yeah, this is a whole different, because this kind of strategy is more about random chance politics, having kids, marrying your cousin, like shit like that, right? You know what I mean? Like marrying your mother, crazy ass shit that happens in this kind of stuff. Very grand strategy focused, something like that. Yeah, I don't know if you could call it grand strategy, but I guess maybe. Oh wait a second, it has battles in it. Oh, so it's not the same. That one doesn't have battles at all. I mean, you do have armies, you fight and stuff, but you don't see them actually fighting or command them. This looks like Rome Total War, right? Their archers
and send soldiers to scale their walls.
Actually, this looks pretty interesting, man. Ain't gonna lie, I like games like this, man.
The people that demand you ride with your knights.
I kind of like games like this, ain't gonna lie.
And the dream of what could be.
Bohemia. The motherland. Oh. It kind of looks interesting, ain't gonna lie. Ain't gonna lie, I'm smidgen interested here.
Europe as the starting point for your legacy. Select a kingdom from anywhere in Europe, North Africa, and even...
What is this stage? It's so weird. Then it's like a CG stage or something.
As head of the royal family, you make all the crucial decisions, like appointing marshals, merchants, clerics, diplomats, and spies to your royal court, instructing them to exert your will across the land. Will you be a cunning diplomat?
Why don't you just say this over the trailer?
A ruthless conqueror. Speaking of conquest, in Knights of Honor 2 Sovereign, you can take direct command of combat yourself and lead your troops in real time. You can also head online to play with multiple friends in epic form with a ton of game mode options to keep the experience fresh.
How do you have teeth this good?
Is grand.
That's what I'm thinking right now.
With all its
like, how do you have such good teeth, man? How much money do you spend on your teeth? You know? Is that like a big spending thing? Or is that like it comes part of your job? You give you the straightest, whitest, most cleanest, like the best smile in the universe teeth?
Traitor.
What is this?
An outcast on two planets.
Because he isn't real?
And nobody else did. And we help him back.
These two have super animated face. I'm just saying. I'm saying. They kind of look like NPCs. None of them are real. I'm glad you guys agree. I'm glad it's not just me, honestly.
Otherwise, I would have cleaned up the place.
Is that your ears? Is that your sexual organ on your head?
You come to hear the legend of the Ulukai.
The Ulukai? Okay.
The Ulukai could fly faster than the Venturi.
Wait a second. This game looks like there was a remake for it. This is like a part two of that remake they released. Because I remember the orange shark.
From the dark of Yod-Gathra to the edge of the moon ruled by Yod-Kar.
The kind of game my brother would like. I bet Glory you'd like this game a lot.
We explore ancient temples unseen for a thousand cycles.
And
awaken their powerful mysteries.
That looks good, actually. Surprisingly good looking game. Oh. He can do some magic.
Like it.
Oh, I'm back, baby. It's like that was the I'm back baby face. That looks pretty good, man.
Oh,
Okay.
In saving a planet, Mar knows that a true hero must also gain the trust of its people.
This is the kind of game that looks good in the trailer, but very janky in real life when you play it. I bet it's gonna be janky. But it's gonna be good. This is like, this is the kind of game that it's gonna get a cult following kind of game. I know, I can feel it from the start. This is a cult following kind of game.
Or for a very reasonable price.
He's finding a Dune worm? Yeah, this is it, man. That's a part two for it. That's pretty awesome. Because the first one was already a very niche, cult-like game that a lot of people like it. Yeah, that's it. Outcast, man. They remade it for the PlayStation, and I think they even released it on PC and stuff.
It's been over 20 years.
Oh, everywhere, basically.
Peel Studios genre redefining and award-winning open-world action adventure took the world by storm. But now, Cutter Slade, your favorite neighborhood invader.
I bet in like few years, 10 years or something, NPCs in video games are gonna look like this. Forget about that. They look like this right now.
Your Slayer is back. Taking control of our hero,
they look like this.
Return to the alien world of Adelpha after being resurrected by the almighty Yods.
Adelpha?
Your mission is to save
almighty
the planet
Yod.
By joining forces with the oppressed Talans and fighting against the invading forces, as well as the dangerous wildlife.
I wonder how it would look like if I had perfect teeth.
As you explore the unique,
like walking around smiling all the time.
Your freedom of movement is simply breathtaking. There's even a jetpack at your disposal. Childhood dream come true.
Yeah, that's the first game ever with a jetpack in it. So
will take the world by storm.
Oh my! I can't wait to play with the jetpack. Enough. How do they come true?
Breaking news here in Sledge.
How did these lizards get the job? I don't know.
Hammer County. After a sharp increase of car racing activity in recent days, authorities now report a staggering amount of items and racetracks popping up out of nowhere. Jan, what do you make of it?
Well, Bill, it's like you say. Random bits and pieces of racetracks along with all different
It seems like our world is a Lego world or something.
And wait, I'm just getting word that these pieces now seem to be rising into the air, forming an ever-expanding aerial racetrack and eclipsing the sky above Sledgehammer. Bill, I've never seen anything like this.
Actually, this looks pretty cool, man. It's Hot Wheels, huh?
And where does it end?
Shadows in the sky.
Why did it end? Is that guy using a... You know what? This is what I respect about video games. This is the shit that I love. This is what I love about video games. The ridiculously crazy shit. One guy, like, you got two racing cars. You got a racing car. You got a drag car. Drag racer car. You got a minibus. You got a freaking... What is this thing? This thing. What? It's like a forklift shit. This is, you know what? This is what I want. This is what I want to see in video games, man. Show me something a little bit out of this world, fun, crazy, playful, just good. Such delightful digital showcase. So far, so good, man. I've seen some good shit in this. Look like my type of game. Yeah, man. Looks pretty fun. Look at that. I want to drive that trucker. Tractor. Look at that. I bet I'll win. Oh, damn. What happened to destructible cars? Remember Burnout games, man? That was fun, man. What do you do in Burnout? You just like smash into other cars and have some crazy like Colosseum runnings, and when your car gets messed up, it looks like shit. Zach the whip with the one bit. Why is that? Welcome to the stream, so. I'm an RPG guy, so I'm putting Baltic on the list of upcoming games. Yeah, why not, man? Might be worth checking out. For sure. Dude, look at that. That's just fun, isn't it? You know what's this? This is what they do on GTA 5. They just make these crazy racetracks in the sky. This is just a game for that. Hey, man, I'll play this. You know what this game is? This is the kind of game that you, like, it's really good. Nobody plays it. And then they release it for free on PS Plus and Xbox Game Pass. And they give it out for free on Epic Games or some shit. This is the kind of game. I'm sorry, but I can already tell this is the kind of game. It's fun. It's a lot of good shit. But Yeah, that's what's gonna happen. They need damage driving physics? For sure, dude. We need games like that where the car gets like
world arcade racing game. And when we say
you're good, glad to hear it, dude.
We are as serious as a highway speeding ticket in Switzerland. There's 400.
Look at this.
The highway speeding.
Look at this. Listen to this joke, man. This is the driest joke. This is the most NPC joke I ever heard. I mean, look at this background as well. Where are they, in space or some shit? Where are these people at?
They open world. We are as serious as a highway speeding ticket in Switzerland.
Wow, that's very serious.
450,000 kilometers or 280,000 miles of roads for racers to go completely and legally mad across a customer.
Remember that we're giving stunt driver, you have to earn points by doing tricks?
That's just over.
Sounds familiar. No, man, I don't remember.
Square miles.
I remember like car racing games, car games used to be so fun.
Multiple categories.
And I don't know what happened. They become so serious.
Build your tracks on the fly and share them.
At least our lizard is doing a better job than the other lizard. Yeah.
Semi-safe. True. Travels.
My God. That interaction with each other is so... It's so organic. What is this? Am I a wolf? Am I a bird? Oh my God. It's Jurassic Park, boys. No, I'm just kidding. It has that feeling, right?
The wilderness, the outdoors.
Looks pretty sweet. Damn, that graphic is good. Remember when you just drive cars and smash each other with rockets and shit? Twisted Metal style. That was the fun days. Ooh, it's like a hunting game. Zachary with the one bit. What is that? Am I a wolf? Am I a dog? No, I am the predator. Way of the hunter. I kill.
Only 4 days to go.
Apex Predator, right here.
Starts on August 16th.
I've seen the Rise of Release for console, so...
You step in to take over your grandfather's small,
PC exclusive?
Business
oh, interesting.
In the Pacific Northwest.
I think you are a lizard.
You find out a rival has taken over the entire
region. That's all other theory.
Illegal and unethical methods of hunting.
Like everybody, RTS? Yeah, I mean, it's hard to bring RTSs on, like, consoles, right? It's not impossible, though. The first Command & Conquer I ever played was on PlayStation 1, by the way. That's how I got into RTS games. Because of PlayStation.
In this open world game, animal and animal herd movements are incredibly sophisticated.
It's not impossible.
And together with hyper-realistic firearms handling and bullet physics, it virtually guarantees an unforgettable, adventurous escape to nature. Whether playing alone or with a friend.
You guys like FPS games where you shoot once an hour?
By the way, just in case you still miss your car,
I mean, you
can road vehicle for you to roam around with. Which acts as your mobile HQ. But much more important than your sensible driving style is your ethical hunting strategy.
Oh my God. The reactions, man. The emotions. By the way, we are NPCs. And the end of this is like going to be a...
Tony.
Hey.
What are you doing?
Brett, hey, what are you doing?
What are you doing?
Is this a video game? Look at this. I'm telling you. These are better NPCs than those NPCs. Okay, this looks... Let's be honest, guys. This doesn't look like a game trailer. All right, this so far, this does not look like a video game trailer, boys.
Don't step on the pizza.
Don't let anybody
step on the pizza. Well, no, get in first. No, leave your bag here. Come on.
What? What's happened?
You got a pizza, boys, in there?
AEW Fight Forever video game happened here.
All right, so, now what?
Well, are you hungry? On second thought, don't eat that. But now, it's finally...
Dude, the pizza, man.
...time to reveal AEW Fight Forever to our AEW fans at the THQ Nordic Digital Showcase. Check it out, Tony. I will be me, the okay. One legendary DMD, and you will be Adam Cole.
I'm man, this game is awesome.
I told you you would love it. Yeah. I told you. Am I ever wrong?
Oh my god, this game is awesome. I'm getting thrashed up. Whoa. You're smacking the shit out of me.
It's tremendous. Are there any weapons in this game?
Are there any weapons?
What is this going on? What is this?
Look how easy this is to play. You didn't have to figure out a million freaking buttons. Oh, even though I could have, because I'm a dentist.
Oh, I know that.
But I just picked it up today and started playing, and I'm already the best at it.
Yeah.
And career mode.
Wow.
Mini games.
Wow, I'm really excited you tell me about career mode, I can tell you that. And I almost lost my mind when I found out that AEW Fight Forever has mini games.
How did you find out about the mini games?
You told me.
AEW Fight Forever, coming soon.
D&D. Knocked your teeth out, Shivani.
Well, at least I know a good dentist.
Oh, my God. I don't know what to say. I don't know. Is this the best trailer or is this the worst trailer on the whole show? I can't tell. It's kind of the best and the worst at the same time. All right, that's it. This is the best trailer, worst trailer ever in the history of video game trailers I've ever seen. It's not even in this show. It's like, this is like 10 years from now, YouTube people are gonna make videos about this fucking trailer. They're like, you've seen the trailer for Fight Forever that was released 2022? These lizards can't get away with it. Oh my god, this is legendary level trailer, boys. This is legend, like... This is legendary level shit. Okay, I... My god, okay.
Players have been offered a mere glimpse of what AEW Fight Forever has.
But it has minigames.
This game delivers the unbridled energy
minigames
and the high-flying, over-the-top personalities synonymous with the All Elite Wrestling League. Plus, I should probably let you know that AEW Fight Forever will be playable for the first time ever inside THQ Nordic's booth at Gamescom in a couple of weeks. So drop by and feel firsthand what it's like to lay down a finisher and feel the pop of the crowd.
This is Corn Hub level of act. I didn't say it. I don't know what that is. Okay. Super has never had a continuation of CNC like last. Red Level was to be cool. I guess, you know, the age of RTS is not... kind of gone, man. Okay, this looks cool. Yeah, man, we need more shit like this, man. This looks fun. Why don't we have something like this Fall Guy but with cars? You know what I mean? Fall Guys, I mean. We should play some Fall Guys, man. That's fun. Okay. Just mess around with from time to time, I guess. I'm surprised it's like more fun than it seems. I mean, it's free to play, so they're not gonna lose anything. Stuntfest World 2?
Stuntfest World Tour hits bang on the sweet spot.
Hits bang on the sweet spot.
An extreme sport.
An extreme sport.
Merge and melt.
Merge and melt.
18 players have to race. 18 players. Wreck and
I can't even, like, I can't be this NPC. I don't even know how to do it.
Elimination-based stunt show. With various outrageous game modes. Take advantage of quirky gadgets.
Quirky
gadgets?
Including
the unique ejection mechanism.
Ejection mechanism.
The competition away. Do you have what it takes to be the best in the fest? Then we've got
Do you have what it takes to be the best in
right
the fest?
After the stream, we have a VIP hours special with only 500 exclusive seats via the stream playtest feature.
At a stream,
you'll be one of the
feature.
First to try out the game and get the chance to compete against content creators online. Later today, we'll increase that number, and tomorrow,
all right, Glory.
Stuntfest World
Enjoy
Tour
your game,
is
man.
Ready for all of you all day. So, let's write stunt history together.
Is someone typing the script as he reads it? Oh, The Cosmic Shake. This looks interesting.
Told you. Look at all those snails the monster kidnapped.
Look, it's Gary.
What happened to Gary, man?
Gary,
see you later, Glory.
Snail seeing us.
Gary is the monster snail.
Huh? They grow up so fast, don't they?
These massive amounts of candy bars must have given him a sugar rush. We can't take him back home like this.
How does he look so cute?
Supply first.
Already on it, buddy.
Okay. Actually, this looks pretty fun, man. I totally play this. I love stuff like this, man. I love platformers, guys. Look at Patrick. He looks so sweet. What happened to you, dude? No. Oh, no. They're in the Hunger Bunga times, dude.
Squidward!
Squid, no, my
so ridiculous,
Squidward,
I want to play it.
Manuga.
Ancient fish! We gotta save our boy! Oh, that's like an ancient whale. Dude! Actually, you know what? I'll totally play this game. This is like literally one of those games that I'll like 100%. Like, I'll play the whole thing. Like, I'll 100% it. I love platformers, boys. And this one looks legitimately really well made. This looks so good. I ain't gonna lie, man. I'm totally playing this. Okay, this is like the number one. Okay, this is like top three, the best game I've seen so far.
Citizen in need.
All right, this is the second best game. After the RTS Command & Conquer one. Hope you guys totally enjoyed what you saw from THQ Showcase. It's pretty sweet. Really like the ISO. I like the fluidity, the movement. It looks fun. It's just one of those really just fun games to play. It's not like you play it, you finish it, you're done. You know what I mean? It's not that complicated. It's not crazy. It's just fun. Going to the Wild West. We got underwater, like the Honga Bonga days. We got the... Yeah, all sorts of different like worlds and arenas. You forget, like, this is like supposedly this is like underwater, boys. Like, we're underwater here, by the way. Looks goofy in a good way. Look at that. What else do you want? You got a solo. Get your juice. They have some brain juice.
Everything is possible in the infinite expanse.
Everything is possible.
There might even be a reality where mayonnaise isn't an instrument. When the mysterious fortune teller Cassandra grants SpongeBob
what?
And Patrick wishes, the two buddies unintentionally open up portals to strange wish worlds. It's all fun and games until their friends get lost in the portals. Explore 7 distinct worlds and don more than 30
my God,
skins
dude.
To rescue the universe of the brand new adventure, SpongeBob SquarePants, The Cosmic Shake. Meet all your favorite bikini bottomites from the series. Voice
how can you be like so
actors.
The definition of NPC
the
people.
Cosmic Shake. Oh, wow. Wow, we made it. I mean, we announced so many.
Okay, now they're more human a little bit.
I have lost count. But let me tell you this, they are in my calendar, and I hope that they're in yours too.
Yep, I can't wait to get probing.
Well,
I bet
sure
you.
Read
yeah, he. Dude, he said it. He said it. He wants to get probing, dude. He wants to get probing.
Thank you so much for being a part of our digital showcase today. We'll see you again soon.
Goodbye.
Bye.
You know what? I'm actually... This is a good showcase, guys. It's not bad at all. I enjoyed a lot of the games. They look pretty good. It's not bad. It was funny because the NPC people. And yeah, I think it was pretty good. Yeah, there's a lot of games here that I'm interested in. It looks pretty sweet house to me. Can't wait for some of them to come out and we get to play and check them out. You know? That's pretty cool. I don't know. You guys let me know what you think about it. I think it was pretty good games, especially the Command & Conquer game. It's not Command & Conquer. I forgot the name of it right now. And SpongeBob SquarePants 2. And some other ones as well. Like, they look pretty cool, man. What about that other game, the number three, the best one, is the one, the Alien Boy, the Alien World. Subtitles will probably have more emotes than him. Oh, yeah. Emotions than him, yeah. Yeah, it's true. Let me know what you guys think. Peace.